And she said, devil, if you're hard-headed, I'm more. I'm going to believe and I'm going to stand for what God has told me. Believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and I shall be saved, me and all my home. You can't have my husband. You can't have my children. You can't have my daughters.
Amen.
Hello?
Amen.
And I told her, lady, I would never preach the word. And look at where I'm at. Amen. What seems to be a setback is now a comeback. And God told me the greatest revival the world has ever seen is yet to come.
Amen.
Amen. And California people, let me tell you that many years ago in Azusa Street, there were some people that locked down and locked with God. And you know what? Believed God. And all of a sudden, the Spirit of the Lord fell. And you know what? There was a great revival that took place. But God needs a protagonist, hallelujah, to make a change and a difference.
Amen.
But you need to take him up for his word. Amen. Amen. Yeah. Taking two steps forward and four steps back. But I'm here to tell the devil, hallelujah, that our setback is now going to be a comeback. Can somebody say that? Can somebody say that? I came to preach to somebody that felt, amen, that your efforts are meaningless, but I'm here to tell somebody that God sees you, God knows your heart, and even though people don't understand you, he's going to make an example out of you, and the people that said you ain't going to add up to nothing, God's going to make something happen with you. In other words, you're going to tear your great mess into greatness.
Right.
Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. Amazing. What the devil makes you think would be a setback, God will turn it into a comeback. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Is somebody ready to come back?
Amen.
Amen. Is somebody ready to do something that's never been done before?
Amen.
And you might be. God is waiting for you. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
And even though we have setbacks and opposition and losses that we didn't even think about, even desire. But I today believe the word of God. And I depend on his Holy Spirit. And having said that, I came to declare to you that your best days are not behind you.
Amen.
They are ahead of you.
Amen. Yes, to come.
I said they are ahead of you. Come on, somebody give them glory right now. Somebody give God glory right now. Amen. I want to invite you to the book of Haggai, chapter 2. And I will fill this house with glory.
Amen.
Amen. Saith the Lord of hosts. Back to worse. But God has a comeback. Amen. Up his sleeves. And you know who that is? That's through you and through me. Amen. And you know the Bible says that he loves the prosperity of his children. He loves it. And he sees us blessed when he sees us prosperous. So now I tell people, if the devil can bless his kids, what makes you think that our God won't bless us?
Amen.
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 Amen. He said, I'll give you houses you didn't build.
Hallelujah.
I'll give you land that you didn't purchase.
Amen.
I'm a witness to that. You know, before I was fighting for a cause that didn't have no significance. I was fighting for a name, for a gang. I was faithful to it. And you know what? At the end of the day, I was left alone.
Mm-hmm.
In parentheses, my best homeboy in the barrio set me up so that my enemies would kill me.
Mm.
But then my enemies came. Hallelujah. They came and surrounded me and they said, hey, it's not that we don't want to kill you. It's just that we can't because before you is an angel that is taking care of you. He's protecting you. He is preventing us from touching you.
Hallelujah.
You know my greatest fear serving the Lord? I said, you know, I used to carry a 45 and a 38. And you know what? My greatest fear is like, how am I going to defend myself now, Lord? Well, that verse that my son just read, you know, on the daily bread, he said, come to peace with me and I'll bring you to peace with
Amen.
Your enemies.
Amen.
And you know what? I'm not going to lie. Sometimes I saw my enemies, and many of you will relate to this, and you know what? My blood would start pumping and the adrenaline would start kicking, and I said, I know what time it is. Hello?
Amen.
But then I tried to take off the other way, and the Holy Spirit would literally grab me and put me right in front of my enemies so that I would experiment that this word is true.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Glory. And this guy came out of prison and he said, "Hey, what's up? We heard you gave your life to the Lord."
Amen.
And I said, "Yeah." You know, I was tripping out. Hello?
Amen.
And he said, "You know what? We respect that."
Amen.
And he said, "You know what? God's going to use me." He started prophesying to me. He said, "God's going to use you to speak to people like us." I'm like, "Amen. What's going on here?" You know what I mean? I said, "This word is real.
That's right.
This word is real. You can stand on it and you can give it credit. You can take it to the bank, baby. Man, it will never wear and tear."
Praise God.
Hello?
Praise God. Amen.
Come on, somebody. Oh, my God. I established a church there in Bruce's that I entitled House of Prayer, praying until something happens.
Amen.
And there I had lockdowns, you know, 3 days Friday. We do a vigil. You know, we lock up. I lock up those doors. Nobody can come in. Nobody can come out until you connected with God.
Amen.
On Sunday, I used to open it up for Sunday service. Amen. And in the nighttime, I had another service, an evening service. And you know what? There, somebody would bring us, you know, a salad and a caldo, you know, a soup, you know, to get back on track. And it was amazing what God began to do. God began to do so many amazing, extraordinary things that I even had a wall in such a powerful way. People were coming out of their homes, and the mother with the daughter that were fought, they were reconciling. Hello?
Amen.
Asking each other to forgive each other. Amen.
Amen.
Fathers with their sons, they were coming out of their homes. Hello? And they were coming out of their homes. You know, nobody was laying hands on them, but the Spirit of the Lord was so heavy.
Amen.
That they were being convicted, convinced that they needed to ask each other for forgiveness.
Yeah.
And once they started hugging and they started weeping, amen, the Holy Ghost laid them. Amen. Boom! They fall in the middle of the street. You know, drunk people was walking a block away with broken bones. And as they walked, they're being healed. Pastors that were discouraged, they ended up being led by the Spirit outside of our service. And he said, this pastor, his name's Pastor Jordan, he said, "I sat outside and the power of God was so strong, it was like a river flowing from me, but it didn't stop there. It came out of the door, and you know what? It touched me. I was out here and I was touched."
Amen.
I was like, wow. That is the power of God.
Amen.
And I seen something. I'm not talking about me, man of God. I'm talking about the power of God when you're able to give him credit for it. Can somebody say amen? Can somebody say amen? And you know what? I'll tell you the truth. We did so many things in the Lord, me and my family. Because you know what? If you see the back of my shirt, it says, you know, if we build a strong home, we'll be able to raise up a strong church. And if we're able to raise up a strong church, we'll be able to raise up a strong community. And if we raise up a strong community, God will permit us to go to the regions, build strong regions, and then from strong regions, God will take us to the nations.
Amen.
It all starts at home, man. It all starts at home. There's a difference between a minister and a good minister. Anybody can minister, but a good minister always starts at home.
Amen.
He always starts at home.
Amen.
You can't be light, amen, in the outside and be darkness in your home. I'm sorry, man, you can't do that. You need to be light in your house.
Right.
There is no best critic than the people that sleep with you.
Amen.
Hello, there's no people that live with you. You know, we can talk to each other and talk cool. It's cool when we're around each other, but what about when we're by ourselves?
Amen.
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 Amen. And I'll tell you what, man of God, we need to rise up. If the devil would come against us, amen, like a flood, God will raise a standard in us. It's time to raise a standard. It's time to come back. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
And I always talk about the church was this, the church was that, and God said, "Hey, what are you going to do about it? What are you going to do about it?" It's time to turn this setback into a comeback. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Give him a round of applause. He is good. He's good. He's good. Stabbed me with one of those needles, you know, that was infected with AIDS. Of course, God didn't permit that. And I have to carry people out of there. Amen. To help them to, amen, to restore their lives. Hello?
Amen.
Amen. And you know what? It's awesome because we're able, I'll tell you the truth. You know, please. Today, and my son will bear witness of this, and the Spirit of the Lord will bear witness to you, that you know what? Before I used to sit in a court and be judged by the judges. Today, amen. I'm not sitting in a place being judged. Now, today, amen, I've been invited to the judges' chambers to pray for them. Today, in our city, God has given me the privilege, amen, to walk into the mayor's office, and hallelujah, he's asking me for prayer.
Hello?
So, in other words, we can be in many places that a lot of people can't. We can relate to a lot of things people can't. And I want to tell you, amen, for a moment, think about everything that has ever set you back. And you thought it was worthless. I want to tell you right now, it wasn't in vain. You can turn that around and use it for the honor and the glory of God. Amen.
The King of all kings.